Thank you for coming to the Spirit of Dance. This is definitely a celebration of dance, and I'm overwhelmed by the turnout. Thank you guys for coming. Why am I here? Why are we here? Very simple. When I was 11, my dance teacher, who I was in ballet, and ballet was the one thing I loved. It was the one thing that no one could take from me. I was going to be Canada's first black arena. Yes, I was. I was going to be with my afro. I didn't care. I had a skinny body and a lollipop head. I was a bobblehead kid. I didn't care. I was going to be the flyest little bobblehead black arena ever. And she said, no, baby girl. Look at all the pictures on the wall. No way. They're all different. I said, God, if I'm meant for anything in dance or anything in life to inspire people to reach their creative dreams and their aspirations and their passions and goals, then take this knife from my stomach. The reason why I'm here today, guys, is because dance saves lives. Literally, I'm living proof. Okay? Before we start, I'd like to invite Blake Pouliot onto stage. Blake, where are you? Hi, baby. Come on up. Go ahead. Blake Pouliot is an amazing rock and roll violinist. For today, he'll be playing Yesterday. On Friday that just passed, August 12th, we lost a dance soldier of our community. His name was Lincoln Russell, affectionately known as War Child. If you know him, give him a hand. He's here. This event is dedicated to him today because before he passed away, we had a conversation and I said, Lincoln, I remember when you were doing capoeira, so strong as the mighty of the mightiest. And I remember when I was homeless and I had nowhere to go when I was living in New York and LA, I called you and you gave me support. I said, I'm going to honor you through my foundation. I'm going to create a scholarship or an award that honors our fallen dance soldiers. Unfortunately, Lincoln wasn't here to see this tonight, nor will he be here to see the rest. But we do this for him, and I hope his memory will live on. Thank you, Blake. Thank you. strong Give Back Foundation. What is it? Well, we are a federally incorporated, not-for-profit operating foundation. Yeah. What does that mean? Okay. In few words, it means that with your generous donations, we are able to then convert that into real, actual programs and events that we don't just talk about. We put it into the community. Okay? Our foundation is all about providing accessibility to the arts, inclusion into dance, and just allowing everyone to achieve, especially youth, to achieve their artistic hopes, dreams, and passions. So our foundation is extremely youth-focused. We have everything that is youth-initiated. All the ideas are youth-driven. And they're all youth initiatives for youth between the ages of 5 to 29. In Canada, I consider youth 35. So youth up to the age of 35. So I'm still youth. Yeah, we just want to provide the openness and the availability, especially to youth in marginalized communities. So one of our pillars is education. If you know me, I'm big into education. I was the biggest nerd in school. I loved school as long as I could do my sports after. So something active kept me there. Didn't matter what it was, dance class, basketball, volleyball, track, whatever. It kept me there. I want dance to do the same for me. I've had a lot of ups and downs. I'm sure everyone has. But for me, success really equals failures. You're going to drop down a lot of times, right? Persistence, a lot of perseverance. You got to keep going when people tell you no in the face of adversity, and a whole hell of a lot of passion. That is what success is to us, not the money. The money will come.
The give back.
Dance program, health and vitality. Okay? So I just like to call Lovika on to have a dance program that's been initiated in Parkdale. It's called Detour. Detour is a 12-week urban dance program where our participants not only get to create their own work, their own routines and dance moves, they also get to create their own dance cartoons that they use as tools to, you know, enrich their learning through the program and when it's done. It was successfully run with the funding of ArtReach Foundation, Laidlaw, and I'm hoping that we can continue that foundation itself. Yeah. We just did it at Canada's National Ballet School. We had over 400 kids this year, over 25 classes. Jean-Marc Généraux joined us, or Jai. Runner-up Amanda Cleghorn taught us her contemporary, and it was a ball. So those two events and programs are what we want to continue, as well as more scholarship.
Why don't you tell them a little something?
Lovika, and I was involved in Detour, a 12-week dance program with Trey Armstrong. And well, one thing I have to say is Detour from here has to grow. It cannot end. If it ends, I will be depressed for the rest of my life. Okay? It's pushing me to grow as a person, as a dancer, as a young woman, and it was a great environment. So please, please, Detour continue, and that's all. Thank you.
Detour Rock! Thank you. I just want to really give a big thank you again to the whole organization of this event. I want to thank so from the bottom, middle, top of my heart, my executive directors, the board of directors. Lovika just mentioned Tanya. Come on stage, Tanya. Lovika just mentioned Tanya. Tanya Burke is one of the members, the board director members. Hello, baby. And she's also the vice president of our dance company that's opening up in Brampton, a dance studio, to continue this for the marginalized and at underserved kids there. So thank you, Tanya, for coming on stage, baby. And thank you guys for coming. This has been a great celebration. Please don't let it stop. Continue dancing. The night is not over. Continue to just dance and keep giving in the spirit of dance, y'all. Thank you for coming, everyone. Enjoy the show. Those who get to stage.